So, today we are going to be making a paper mache castle, and I'll show you the design of it. I'll make a basic shape out of cardboard, and then I'll do some paper mache with a paintbrush all over it to make it give it that stony sort of texture. Okay, so I'm going to start by doing like a cutout so I can cut out the drawing and stick it to a bigger piece of card maybe. Or maybe I won't have a base, maybe I can move it around just the way it is. But anyway, let the time lapse begin. Have you subscribed? Because if you haven't, then you won't get that burger from McDonald's that you've always wanted, and you'll also find that a refrigerator has been thrown right through your house. So subscribe now. Cardboard shape of it, and now I think it's soon ready to put on the paper mache. Take a look at this. Ooh. I'll put the paper mache all over it and it'll be rock solid. Okay, so now that I've got all the paper mache ready, I can start gluing it on, but the truth is first I need to start ripping off little bits of tissue paper for the paper mache, and yeah, enjoy. So it's been some time and I've started doing the paper mache, and hopefully you should get the idea. I put a bit of glue down, put the paper mache paper on it, then I do a layer of glue over it, and I keep on doing. And show what it looks like after it's been a few minutes. You can see that the wall is already starting to build up, and I deliberately gave it that splodgy look to make it look quite bumpy, as it's a dark, evil fortress wall. And I could just do all the paper mache myself, or I could use a bit of magic tricks. So I finished the paper mache and I didn't want to do too much work off camera, and you're probably wondering why there are a few gaps where the paint mache isn't. Because I want this to be based on like a lavery volcano texture. So if I added some yellow and red, yellow and orange in those gaps, and to do a bit over the parts where I missed the paper mache, like there, it'll just give it some more detail. While you're watching the montage of me painting, I've got a couple of pro tips. Number one, add a bit of water to your PVA glue so when you stick on the paper mache, it makes it easier to stick down and make sure that it doesn't come off when you take the paintbrush off. Number two, the one word is perseverance. It takes a long time to do this, especially when you haven't done it before. So you need a lot of confidence and perseverance to just keep on trying to do it, because it can be frustrating sometimes.